Ask you one question. How to get the job and what things are necessary to work in a corporate world and to excel in our profession? Okay, so one by one I will ask you questions. Yes, what do you think? Which quality do you need? Very good. Communication. Again?
Leadership quality.
Yes.
Knowledge
about our profession. Yes.
We need attitude.
Yes. Again?
Decision making power.
Yes.
Discipline.
Confidence.
Very good. Confidence. We need confidence. We need in each and every profession. Not only for work, but whenever we go and we want to perform something, we should have confidence. Okay. So these are the skills. Yes. You want to say something?
Soft skills.
Yeah. So soft skill is the pack of many skills. Okay. So today we are going to talk about soft skills. But before that, I'll tell you there are many skills which we need to get the job and to work in a company and to achieve our professional goals. These skills are divided into two parts. What are those two parts? Hard skill and soft skill. What are the hard skills? The degrees, the diploma, the certificates which we get after completing a course in a specific duration. That is called hard skill. But what about soft skill? Soft skill we have to develop. So the things which you have shared here, like confidence, communication, leadership qualities, decision making ability, these all are called soft skills. So today we are going to talk about the most important soft skill. Can you tell me which is the most important soft skill? In all skills, which is the key skill? Can anyone? Very good. Communication skill. Because we call it the key skill. If you don't have some other skill, but you have only communication skill, it can help you to get the jobs and it can help you to survive in any profession. So our today's topic is communication skill. In the series of soft skill, the first we'll talk about communication skill. Can anyone tell me what is mean by communication?
Conversation between the two persons and the exchange of knowledge and information.
Yes. Again, more explanations? Yes.
Representation of thoughts, knowledge, ideas, and information.
Very good. Very good. Okay. Now my next question. What is necessary for effective communication? What we should do for making our communication effective?
Confidence.
Okay, we should have confidence. Again.
Eye contact.
Very good. Now this is the part of communication that we should make eye contact. Again, more
body language.
Very good. We should have body language. So I'll tell you the communication skill. First of all, what is communication? Communication is the exchange of ideas, exchange of words, where one person sends a message and the other person receives the message. If this process of exchanging idea and words is effective, then only we can call it effective communication skill. Okay. Now in communication also, we have two parts of communication. One is verbal communication, another is non-verbal communication. Okay. What is verbal communication? Where we use the words, we exchange the words. And what is non-verbal communication? Apart from exchanging the words, whatever we do while speaking, while communicating with the people, that is called non-verbal communication. And what are the things included in non-verbal communication? Our body language, our expressions, eye contact, your pitch of voice, your gesture, your posture, your nodding, all these things are included in non-verbal communication. And believe me, if your non-verbal communication is effective, then only you can make effective verbal communication. Because whatever we speak, we don't just deliver the words, we need to push it with non-verbal activities. For example, if I want to say you thank you, so I should not only deliver the words, I should put my words with my body, with my expression, and I should say thank you so much. So this is the communication skill where non-verbal part of communication plays very important role. So this much only for today's session. In next session we'll talk about the next skill which is very important in the series of